Cheers.
Cheers.
Hi friends, so today I am back with another video with my beautiful mother. This is what we are doing today. We are doing a nice pizza talk. The questions are currently coming in and I'm very excited. I tweeted for you guys to send in questions with the hashtag #MomAndMeg, and I'm gonna go check out the hashtag and see what you guys need advice on. Also, if you would like to see us making this pizza, I uploaded a video on Monday of us making it, having our cooking show, and it was great. My friend Riley asked us, what's your best tip for starting a new healthy lifestyle and getting out of unhealthy habits? Having one day where you just break the pattern. Like, if there's one day where you just know that you'll just be sitting in your bed or something, or when you come home from school and you just automatically go to your bed, maybe be like, you know what, today instead of going home and sitting down, I'm just gonna go for a walk. And that would be one, you know, just getting out there.
Yeah, I think setting a start date is really important. But even before you set the start date, do like a 7-day transition. Maybe you have a really good book that you like, a method that you really believe in. And once you have that, study the method. For 7 days, let that be your kind of scrub period. Like, you're just weaning in. There's no mistakes. You're learning something new. Go easy on yourself. I think if you do that, then when you're ready for your start date, you're gonna have it down.
Erica asked us how to fix your relationship with your mom. The best thing to do in the daughter's aspect is writing her a letter. I feel like it's a lot easier to just get all of your thoughts out there instead of having like a very heated conversation, especially when you're on bad terms. Just writing a letter is so much easier. You can get everything out that you need to say, cover all of your points, and it's good.
And it allows your mom to really see your perspective of the situation. You could have 10 people in the same room watching the same movie, and 10 people would have a different perspective of that. The same goes for your relationship.
And sometimes it's really hard to understand where the other person's coming from because you're literally not them. I've talked about this before in pizza talks, like, you can't fully wrap your head around something that somebody else has been through if you've never been through it yourself, because they're literally just a different person. Communication is the best to fixing any situation, so I'd say, like I said before, write your mom a letter. NJ is her name, but she asked us, how would you maintain a vegetarian lifestyle with a meat-eating family?
Like anything when you're starting out, a really good thing to do is something like chili, because what's in the chili pot can be completely vegetarian, vegan.
Vegetarian chili.
Do the meat separate. And the people that want meat in the chili can put it in.
So many of you guys have like abbreviated names on Twitter, but C asked us, my best friend recently moved really far away. How can I keep our friendship strong? You just have to make the effort if you want the relationship to actually, you know, stay a relationship, sorry for the burp, that you actually, it's, you know, it's two-way street. You can't be like, oh my gosh, they totally just left me in the dust. Like, you're also not trying.
I think that if it's a relationship that the universe has intended for you to have, like when you screw up like that and you don't keep in touch with the person, they'll come back into your life in some other way.
Yeah.
And so now I had this friend of mine and she moved to Greece and I didn't even know that. And I went about my life and we got together about 30 years later.
Was it like old times?
I went to then see her in Greece. It was like no time ever passed. She's on the other side of the world. We meditate together. She leads retreats and I will go, and if it's a place in between here and Greece, I'll go just so that I can see her. But we both know that we don't need to see each other to love each other and to feel each other every single day, in every single moment. She knows when I'm feeling her, I know when she's feeling me.
That's so
cool. And it fills me up. They're there whether they're physically there or not.
Jenna asked, how do I figure out what I want to do in life? I get stressed out thinking about the future and how to be successful. And I think that this is something that a lot of teenagers struggle with, especially when you're trying to figure out like if you want to go to school, or what you want to be, and those kind of things. Just kind of figuring out where you want to take your life from that point. That's a really scary thing for a lot of people. My number one tip is being here now, and actually just being in the present moment, and not being like worried about the 500 things that you think you have to do, or the things you have to prepare, or worrying about test scores and that whole kind of thing. Like, everything will come in due time. You just have to do the most productive thing for every moment.
Yeah, and I think, there's tremendous value in talking to a lot of people. Talk to grown-ups about what they do. Watch what people do. But at the end of the day, know what you do that's so unique to your purpose in being here. you could say like, oh, like for me, I'm going to school, I'm gonna be a physical therapist because I like helping people. But what else? Like what makes that? I love this idea of a dual major, that there's something that will pay the bills and also greatly interest you, right? But then there's this other piece that comes in that makes it all your own. So to be a physical therapist that's also a yoga therapist, there's not a lot of people that do that. If you can pick two things, what do you do well? What are your gifts and your talents? Don't go into that, why am I here? Everybody does that, but why am I here is gonna be answered later. It's already been decided. So be okay with the idea that it's already been decided. How long it takes for you to find that is
your own journey. How,
yeah, it's your own journey, really.
This is an interesting question from Risa, and she asks, what's the best / most important general life advice you have?
Love, which sounds really corny, but it's the healer for everything. In a time where we are right now politically, where the world is kind of crazy, we can be a model for loving people in your own community, just reaching out and deciding how you could serve,
yeah,
how you could help somebody. You don't have to go like do a big service project, but maybe you help somebody in the grocery store. Maybe there's somebody behind you with an infant that's fussy and you have just a few items. There's some goodness that you feel in allowing them to go before you, and that fills up the happy bucket. So when people talk to me about like, I'm so unhappy, how do we, it's, you can't just flip the switch and go, oh, today,
I'm
gonna have a happy day. Oh, no, I'm happy. So it's like, that's resisting the unhappiness. If we wanna fill the happy bucket, we're gonna fill it with service, by serving other people or serving the planet. Those two things fill up the happy bucket. Seek happiness in all that you do.
Yeah.
And love people in spite of the fact that they're going through whatever they're going through.
I kind of go off a little bit of what you said and say that my biggest life tip is to find some kind of way to help, because I think that's like somewhat of a reason why we were all put here. We weren't just put here to be like, oh, you know, just mess it up, just go ahead. Like, we all should find some way to help out in this world, because, you know, we don't know how much we can make an impact on this and also for the generations after us. So I'd say, I also mentioned this in my strip down challenge. I was like literally getting choked up. I was like, just find some way in this world, whether it be like doing videos on the internet or something like that, or just offering advice and like help and love, some kind of service in your school or in your community. I think it's just really important to find your niche and just find some way to help the world. Okay, this is gonna be our last question, and it's from Emily, and she asks, how do I spread positivity and show your true personality in everyday life, in parentheses, school, etc.? Love you guys. We love you too. Honestly, smiling is the best part, but really, a smile is so inviting, and if you see somebody just frowning around the hallways, you're not gonna want to talk to them, so it's always easier to just... It's always easier to just smile and just to be friendly in that way.
It's just funny talking about that, because last week I went for a walk in the woods, and it's kind of a suburban area, and people are like getting their workout on, they're really serious about it, and I was listening to John Denver, and you can't listen to John Denver and not smile. Yeah. Like, it's just smiling music. So I'm in the woods, I'm in a happy place, I'm smiling, and I started doing that exact thing, like, Can you smile people?
Not even just
into
like
into happiness.
So many people do this too, like when you're past people on the street, you know, just a little grin. But that's not even it. Like, you gotta do the full toothy grin for them to actually
greeting,
yeah.
Greeting people. I also believe, I was talking to my son about this today, that every day, meet somebody new, and don't just say hello. Maybe there's somebody behind you in the coffee line. You're both there in line, so
spark up a little,
you know, a little bit of a conversation.
That's so important. I'm reading this book right now. I've talked about it 500 million times. There's a part in it that's like, so many people today are just very touch and go, like, you're playing a role for me, so I don't need to have like an actual connection with you, whether it be like the people at the grocery store and stuff like that. Even extending an actual real life connection to them is so important, because it makes people's day so much brighter. They're like, I'm not just sitting here like a robot, just like doing things for you as you leave, you know, like actually making eye contact with,
yeah,
people, and not just like rushing through things. It's better to actually make the,
yeah,
connection. This was an awesome pizza talk, and I just wanted to say thank you to my mother for being on this. this. I'm really glad that this actually happened. No problem.
It's really fun.
It's really fun. I love filming vids, and you know, it's nice to have my mom be a part of it as well. So I will of course link the cooking video in the description and somewhere up here so you guys can check that out as well. And yeah, just give this video a thumbs up for my mother and advice and things and being back in my old room and being home.
I know.
Yes. I hope you guys enjoyed this video. If you did, like I said, give it a thumbs up, and I will see you guys in my next one. Stay smiling. Bye. Babe, it's been so long.